out. I'm a little George.
That's a healthy fish. That's about 2 pounds. Fat.
Using the snell knot. I was wondering where my bobber stoppers were. There they are. So the snell knot, and I kind of was wondering if I liked it, because you get hung up a little bit or snagged, and you pull it out, you jack your bait up, and you got to get another one. You can't just like ease it out of there. Set the hook. I do not worry about whether they're going to be a hook. It's like it's in there. So tell me your favorite knot for flipping. I should be trying something else.
sprayed. It's tearing my hands, fingers up.
That's from braid.
Feathering it with my
long fall. It's got that nice tip on it too. That sucks. Well, I probably need to retie anymore. Cuts his rod tips off all the time. Back in Stanford, so. So that was what, 12, 13 feet? I haven't caught anything less than probably 15. Thank you.
go. Was not a definitive hit. Guys, if you see a bunch of junk,
big stuff,
say what I used to say, I can't fish in that, I can't cast. Get you a nice rod, or heavier rod, get some braid, get it cheap on eBay. Start catching your donkeys like that. My reality is, I never fished around a lot of thick grass like this until I moved here, to Florida. And usually I would get the lightest rod I could get away with. Throwing like, I always threw worms on really light sinkers. So if I could get away with a medium, I'd do a medium. show y'all what that fish came at.
They're in there.
They ain't gonna catch themselves. You gotta get out here and catch them. They ain't gonna catch themselves. Let's go. Let's go. Oh my God, my fingers rubbed wrong. I gotta lift them left hand.
Ching.
Take a picture of.